Joining us on the show today is Art Berman. He's a well-known geological consultant. He's the director of Labyrinth Consulting Services and also a director of the Association for the Study of Peak Oil and Gas here in the U.S., also known as ASPO. And Art, as you know, oil is one of the most critical commodities for the functioning of our global economy and modern society. It's used for transportation, the making of plastics, rubber, and over 100 other items that we use on a continual basis. So with that said, we have seen a lot of volatility in the oil space over the past couple decades, at least going back even further. We can see large moves up and down. And we know that when oil went from as little as $10 in the late 90s to over $140 in 2008, people were really concerned about peak oil. But then we had the financial crisis in 2008. The price of oil collapsed down to $33 before rising eventually back to the $100 range. And just this year, it collapsed again down to as low as $26 a barrel when we look at the West Texas Intermediate crude contract. Given that oil has now remained in a much lower, though volatile range over this past year and a half, really since the beginning of 2015, the question I want to ask you, is peak oil no longer a concern, or has it simply been pushed out much further due to the shale boom?
I think that peak oil, it's one of those unfortunate terms that we're never going to get away from. But let's just talk about what I mean when I talk about peak oil. First of all, it has nothing to do with running out of oil. That's the first misconception. The world has an awful lot of oil in it. Nobody knows exactly how much we've used, but let's just say we may have used half of it, okay? Something, you know, maybe a little bit more, maybe a little bit less. So peak oil is not about running out of oil. What peak oil is about is running out of affordable oil. So when people initially went exploring for oil and natural gas, just like anything else, gold, silver, you know, uranium, you name it, they're going to go after the easy stuff first. And if it's easy with oil and gas, that means it's shallow. That means it's relatively inexpensive to drill for and to produce. And the quality of it is probably pretty good. And so as you progressively work through consumption, the easy, cheap, good stuff, we're forced to drill deeper, use more technology, go offshore, and often start using oil that's of lower quality. And so basically what all that says is that by certainly the end of the 20th century, we as a world had pretty much gone through most of the easy, cheap stuff. And when oil starts costing more than it used to, then everything costs more than it used to. And the fact that we cannot seem as a world to get out of the economic doldrums that we're in right now, to me, is absolutely logical. No mystery in it at all. And I just told you the answer. Oil costs 3 or 4 times more than it did 20 years ago. And if everything, therefore, costs more to manufacture, transport, distribute, package, then guess what? The world's in trouble. The economy's in trouble because the cost of everything just went up. That simple. Now, obviously, there are complexities to it, but economists spend an awful lot of time worrying about things that usually don't include the cost and availability of energy, incredible as it seems. These are very intelligent people. Don't get me wrong. I'm not being critical. But from what I read and know, very few economists consider the cost of resources or their availability in their models. So the Federal Reserve and the European Central Bank and the Bank of Japan and the People's Bank of China, they're all doing all this, you know, very esoteric kind of stuff to try to get the world economy growing again. And to me, I'm sure all that is good stuff. But if we don't address the fact that the master resource now costs 3 or 4 times as much as it did not very long ago, we're kind of picking around the edges. We're missing the main point and the main problem.
So let me ask you to clarify that a little bit, because you say that the cost of oil is now much higher than it did in the past. At least when we look at the price of oil itself, if we go back, you know, just several years back to 2014 and prior to then, you know, oil was at the $100 barrel range, was averaging close to that for many years. And now, I believe on the day you and I are speaking, it's right around the mid-40s. So at least when we look at the price, it has come down considerably. Are you referring to the cost of extracting the oil?
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's Financial Sense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.